don't know how we're going to pick these six. Any ideas?
Later, Catherine and Freddie from BMG Records Dublin arrive out to celebrate.
Nadine, hi.
Welcome.
Hello.
How are you?
Nadine Coyle. I'm from Larkhill and Derry. Did a birth 15th of the 6th, 85. Making me a Gemini. And what's it a birth did I say now? 15th of the 6th.
During her interview, Nadine gave an alarming date of birth. The 15th of June 1985 makes her 16. All band members must be 18 or over. That night, the series begins. They watch Programme 1 together. However, the producer returns to the office to check all the application and legal forms Nadine has signed. On these, she's given her date of birth as the 15th of June 1983, making her 18.
When we asked you yesterday your date of birth,
I give you the wrong date of birth.
Are you sure?
Aye.
Definitely. What is it?
I think 15th of 6th, 87 or something. I saw.
No, sorry. You said 85. Which means that you wouldn't be 18.
I would be 16.
Yeah.
No, I give the wrong date of birth.
What's your date of birth?
83. And that's what I says to them was last night. I says, I think I give her the wrong date of birth. I think I'll give...
Have you got your passport?
Mm-hmm.
With you?
No. Oh, should have it with me.
Nadine still seems confused about her date of birth.
But did I give the wrong date of birth? What did I give?
85.
I don't have it at all. Mama, did you give me my passport whenever we...
Nadine phones home looking for her mislaid passport.
Because, Amanda, yesterday I was getting an interview done and I gave the wrong date of birth. I gave a wrong date of birth anyway. So I'm just looking for my passport. But it's not in the handbag. And I checked on the bag, emptied it out. Oh, could have. I think the bag's fair. Daddy's going out to look in the car to see what's in the car. It was an interview thing, and I gave the wrong date of birth. Like, and I was sitting in the captain. I don't know, I was sitting and I says 15th of the 6th. I thought it says 87, but she says it says 85. 15th of the 6th, 85, which would have made me younger. Like, so I was just sitting there and I was giving, and then I says then later on, God, I think I gave the wrong date of birth. I know, tell me about it. I don't know, if my passport's in Derry, what do you do?
Post it down to us.
Just post it down, after.
To the office?
Just post it down to the office. What a gag. 15th of the 6th.
Nadine, your date of birth is something that you normally lose.
I know.
So I just panicked when I...
No, it was me. Like, it was me should have panicked. That's why I says, God, is that right? Is that... I thought it says 87 that I was working out. I said, what about 87? Make me 14, 13, 14.
Later, Larry Bass, the series producer of Popstars, phones Nadine's dad in Derry.
Hello, Niall?
Yes?
This is Larry Bass, the series producer with Popstars.
Yes, fine.
How you doing? We have one concern, Niall, which we're hoping you can help us with.
Right.
I'm currently being filmed at the moment, and you're on speakerphone. Yeah. It's off speakerphone now. We have a concern over Nadine's age. And what we'd like you to do is to help us with that. If you could come down to Dublin tomorrow with either her passport or her birth certificate. Would you be able to do that? obviously, like, she's over 18 and everything else, but we haven't got a concern, and obviously we have to, you know, put this issue to bed. We really do have to have either a passport or a birth certificate tomorrow at 2 o'clock for Nadine. If not, Nadine can't stay in the band. It's as simple as that.
Linda Martin goes to Nadine's room to chat.
You'll break my heart. If I have to lose you, and it's stupid me saying if I have to lose you, but that's the way I feel now. I just feel that the bond and the friendship is so strong between all of us. I'll just crack up.
I'm just looking forward to tomorrow. Just getting it over me.
And your daddy's coming in.
Oh, he's got my mommy and daddy.
And they're bringing what? Were they bringing down?
They're going to look for the passport to see if, because they can't find it. I think it was in the car.
Yeah.
So, and they're going to look for that. And if not, they're going to look for the birth certificate.
How did you make that mistake? God bless, isn't it?
I was sitting and I think this is 15th, this is like 87. There's some date of birth I got, which made me look. Because I went down and I was nervous and I was sitting there and I saw. No, and it was just the first.
But you were 16 anyway. Surely to God, you'd have to still be at school.
I would still be at school if I was 16.
Or somebody would be asking questions. They'd be asking your parents why she's not in class.
There would be a whole uproar.
There would, of course.
Still unsure what date of birth she gave in her interview, Nadine assures Linda she's 18.
If you were trying to make out that you were 18, that you were, would you tell me at this stage?
I would tell you at this stage.
As your friend?
I would tell you. It's only right, I think.
While the cameras were not rolling, Nadine finally broke down and confessed to Linda that her real date of birth is the 15th of June, 1985, making her 16. She then tells the other five her secret.
I had to be too good to be true like them.
I think it was very brave what she did.
Yeah, it was.
Come in and face all you guys.
Because if it was me, I don't know if I'd be able to do it.
You might have just run away. Yeah, but I think it was very brave what she did. Come here to me.
No, I know it's only 2 days, but it seems like way longer, you know what I mean? And for just somebody else to come in and take her place, it just doesn't feel right.
The other five of us here, we are at the age, and we're after putting ourselves through so much the last couple of weeks, and we're completely gone from our home life and everything into here, and it's just going to shatter us, and if they've any respect for us, they'll do what make us happy, what make us happy to have Nadine here, so I hope they make an exception.
We'll have to try to do something, okay, guys?
Yeah, definitely.
Emotions run very high.
Hi, this is Sinead.
Sinead phones Larry Bass, the series producer.
Is there any chance that you'll be able to come down to us now? At all? It's just that there's something we need to talk to you about.
Liam calls the band's lawyer in London.
It's one of the band members that has actually been chosen has turned out to actually not be 18. They're actually only 16, and at this stage we're being told that she has to actually leave the band as soon as possible. So when you get this message, could you ring me or some of the other band members as soon as possible? It's obviously a very serious matter, like, and we need to get it sorted out as soon as possible.
We've made such a bond now for someone else to come in, to take Nadine out and to put somebody else in the band. Just seems like it wouldn't be right. We don't feel that we could go on like with putting somebody else in the band, and because I'm with such a talent, like, and to be just taken away, I think for being 18 should be just like, it's all such a minor little thing, couldn't it be just thrown out the window?
There's nothing that I can do, nothing. Before we even wrote contracts, before we even advertised Popstars in Ireland, we got it checked out. It stated even on the phone line, giving out the information about the auditions. You have to be over 18. In every press advertisement, you have to be over 18. In every form that you signed, you have to be over 18. Now, we didn't do that lightly. I'm also in a situation where our production company could be sued by the people who were turned away because they weren't 18. If there was anything we could do, we would have done it. That's what we asked at every stage. And the last question that I asked all 32 finalists in RTE when I was telling everybody about where we're going or what we're doing. Is there anyone in this room who is not over 18?
Popstars, just this once, can't you bend the rules? Like, just make it different this one time.
Unfortunately, there's nothing the band, the production team, or the lawyers can do. The following afternoon, Nadine leaves to meet her parents in the city centre and return to Derry.
They can't even see me, can they?
Drag yourself over the coals. I know you're sorry to go, but when all you can do is say so, I know it's over.
Join us next week on Popstars when Louis meets Nadine's parents.
Her plan was to take you to one side and go away.
She can't be in the band. And she has to go back to Derry because she's today.
I have a definite.
And it is decided who is to replace Nadine in the band.